Want to join us on a trip? Let's start in Greece.
Hi, I'm Hamid from Afghanistan. I arrived in Lesbos in 2016. At first, I stayed in the reception center of Moria. Since I didn't know anyone, I decided to join the activities organized by the Hellenic Red Cross and become a volunteer. I then moved to Athens, where I received help with my asylum request, got informed about my legal rights, and was provided psychosocial support at the Hellenic Red Cross Multifunctional Center. Today, I am an active Hellenic Red Cross volunteer helping refugees as an interpreter in the hotline. I also attended Greek classes and became a mediator at the Accompanied Referrals Interpretation Service that supports migrants and refugees in accessing health services. I feel proud, safe, and part of the local community.
Moving to Croatia, let us meet Amen, a refugee and a Croatian Red Cross caseworker, and Aziza, an asylum seeker. When Aziza and her children arrived in Croatia, they were desperate and confused. Amen, who years before also migrated from the same home country, understood their situation and was able to help and explain to them the local culture and traditions. Amen started working for the Croatian Red Cross in 2015. This gave her the great opportunity to learn, develop herself professionally, and achieve financial independence. Thanks to Amen and other refugee support, the Croatian Red Cross realized that their programs were more efficient when including interpreters and cultural mediators with migrant or refugee backgrounds.
Moving on to Spain, we encounter Marta and David, both Spanish Red Cross volunteers. They have recently attended a Red Cross training on gender equality. Since its very beginning, they started to think of ways to reduce gender stereotypes still rooted in society. The training is only one of the actions foreseen by the Spanish Red Cross gender strategy. A study on women's presence and access to governance also was conducted, revealing that, even though women are the majority among volunteers and workers, they are a minority within the governing bodies. With the Red Cross elections of 2019, progress has been made and currently, greater actions are being developed to guarantee that women's representation within the governance is balanced.
Finally, let's travel to Italy to meet Filippo, a young boy who has been a victim of discrimination because of his sexual orientation. After suffering many times the hatred of others, Filippo decided to join Refuge, a protection house for young LGBTQ people, victims of violence, discrimination, and homotransphobia. Here he finally found a place where he felt safe, understood, and relieved, and in which he could think about his future. Once he joined Refuge, the Italian Red Cross assisted Filippo psychologically and legally and helped him developing his life project. Filippo has been able to train and expand his skills, find a job, and become independent. Now Filippo has finally found a house of his own where he feels safe and free to be himself. We loved learning with you about our friends, proud to be part of an organization committed to gender equality, and discover how it is possible to change realities, making them more equitable, diverse, and inclusive. Through the 2020 IFRC Gender and Diversity Policy and the Resolution No. 5 of the 33rd International Conference of the Red Cross and Red Crescent, the movement calls us to redouble our efforts for concrete actions on gender and diversity within the projects and the power structures, culture, and dynamics of our institution. These actions are only an example of how the Mediterranean national societies work in ensuring that no one is left unsafe, no one is left behind, and no one is left out. So now it's your turn. What are you doing to transform your organization into a more gender-sensitive and diverse one?